बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम, अस्सलाम वालेकुम डियर स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज डॉक्टर शहाना एंड वी आर लर्निंग फार्मेसी प्रैक्टिस। टुडेज टॉपिक इज बेसिकली रिलेटेड टू दी कोरोनरी आर्टरी डिजीज। द सब टाइप इज दी एंजाइना पेक्टोरस एंड टुडे वी विल डिस्कस दी ट्रीटमेंट। व्हाट आर दी ट्रीटमेंट गोल्स टू मैनेज दी सिम्टम्स ऑफ दी एंजाइना? दैट इन एंजाइना पेक्टोरस देयर इज डिक्रीज ऑक्सीजन सप्लाई टू दी हार्ट दैट लीड टू दी जनरेशन ऑफ दी चेस्ट पेन। इफ यू टॉक अबाउट दी एम्स गोल, इट इज बेसिकली रिलेटेड टू दी पेशेंट क्वालिटी ऑफ लाइफ। फर्स्ट इज टू रिलीव द सिम्टम्स ऑफ द पेन। सेकेंड टारगेट इज टू स्लो डाउन द प्रोग्रेशन ऑफ द डिजीज एज वी इज कंटिन्यूस डिपोजिशन ऑफ द फैट्स एंड लिपिड्स इन द माइक्रोवैस्कुलेचर एंड मैक्रोवैस्कुलेचर ऑफ द ब्लड एंडोथीलियम स्मूथ मसल सेल्स। दिस डिपोजिशन विल ट्रिगर सेवरल टाइप्स ऑफ ब्लॉकेज इन द आइदर इन कोरोनरी आर्टरीज और आइदर इन अ सेरेब्रल आर्टरीज और आइदर इन अ पेरिफेरल आर्टरीज दैट लीड टू डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ कार्डियोवैस्कुलर डिजीजेस। इफ यू टॉक अबाउट द कार्डियोवैस्कुलर डिजीजेस, दिस देयर मे बी अ सेरेब्रोवैस्कुलर डिजीज और देयर मे बी अ पेरिफेरल वैस्कुलर डिजीज। पेरिफेरल में भी जा सकता है वो जो क्लॉट है, दैट क्लॉट विल डिटैच फ्रॉम द एंडोथीलियम एंड इट मे फॉर्म अ एम्बोलस। दिस एम्बोलस मे गो टू द ब्रेन एंड इन कैरोटिड आर्टरी इट कैन लीड टू द स्ट्रोक और इट मे गो अप टू द लेग्स दैट लीड टू द डीप वेन थ्रोम्बोसिस and they may lead to the severe pain in the legs. So the second main target is to slow down the progression of the disease and to then we have to prevent the future events. Like these future events may be a myocardial infarction, may be the stroke or may be any other depending upon the organ affected by a thrombus or embolus. For acute attacks we need a vasodilator that are cardio-selective. So for that, these types of patients, they need cardiac vasodilators and among them organic nitrates or nitrites are the first choices that should be included in their dosage regimen. Organic nitrates relaxes the vascular smooth muscles and this relaxation is depending on the nitric oxide. Nitric oxide activates the guanylate cyclase and it increases the CGMP, which is the cyclic guanosine monophosphate. This elevated CGMP ultimately result in the dephosphorylation of the myosin light chain and resulting in the vascular smooth muscle relaxations. The most common one is the nitroglycerin that causes the dilation of the larger veins and this reduces the preload of the heart that return to the heart and therefore reduces the work of the heart. This mechanism is outside from the heart. However, nitrates also dilates the coronary vasculature providing the increased blood supply to the heart muscles. So at both level they are dilating the blood vessels at the heart level and at the organ level. That preload is also reduced and the workload of the heart is also reduced. This organic nitrates is mainly reserved for the acute attacks of the angina pectoris. However, it is also reserved for the prophylaxis to prevent such type of chest pains attacks. Then we have other choices. For that purpose, we have beta blockers, we have calcium channel blockers, we have ranolazine and we have other option which are the potassium channel opener, that is the nicorandil, and we have certain anti-thrombotic drugs and anti-platelets. How we can achieve this type of goal? Increase oxygen demand, जो है, उसको हमें basically reduce करना है, जो cardiac उसकी जो है हार्ट की जो डिमांड है ऑक्सीजन की वो बढ़ गई है. वी हैव टू रिड्यूस ऑक्सीजन डिमांड. फॉर दैट पर्पस वी विल यूज द बीटा ब्लॉकर्स, वी यूज द कैल्शियम चैनल ब्लॉकर्स दैट डिक्रीजेस द हार्ट रेट, दैट डिक्रीजेस द कॉन्ट्रैक्टिलिटी, दैट डिक्रीजेस द प्रीलोड एंड दैट डिक्रीजेस द आफ्टर लोड. ऑर्गेनिजम्स आर सप्रेस्ड by the beta blockers and calcium channel blockers. Second option is that we decreases the preload and afterload, and this is achieved by the nitrates and the calcium channel blocker. Above two factors are reduced by the beta blockers, and the last two factors are reduced by the nitrates and the calcium channel blocker. If we alter the oxygen supply, then it is achieved by the use of the nitrates and the calcium channel blocker, or it can also achieve by use of the antithrombotic agents or statins that basically reduces the deposition of the platelets to the heart endothelium, or decrease the cholesterol or fats or LDL level. It also facilitates the reduction in the symptoms of the coronary heart disease that also lead to the decrease in the progression of the disease. What are organic nitrates? They are vascular smooth muscles relaxant, and they basically convert into an active form that releases the nitric oxide in a endothelium blood vessels that increases the intracellular level of the cyclic GMP. This dephosphorylation of the myosin light chain is responsible for the decrease in the cytosolic calcium and the relaxation of the smooth muscles. This endothelium derived relaxing factor is the nitric oxide. These nitrates are responsible for the relaxation of the vascular smooth muscles. They are having the ability of vasodilation. Then we have nitric oxide mediated guanylyl cyclase activation that inhibits the platelet aggregation. यानी ये क्या करते हैं, another जो mechanism है myocardial infarction को जो lead कर सकता है उसको inhibit करते हैं, and that dependent on the nitric oxide. Furthermore, they also relaxes the smooth muscles of the bronchi and the GIT. What are the examples? Nitroglycerin, isosorbide mononitrate and isosorbide dinitrate. Most important thing regarding the nitrates is that pharmacokinetic is very important, as it is basically related to the heart damage. The more the time of the chest pain, there will be the more chances of the heart damage. So the duration is start from sublingual tablets are available for the patient, and patient are advised to keep these tablets along with them so that in case of the acute attacks, he or she should be able to immediately keep these medications under his tongue. For that purpose, the time is being starting from the 1 minute, and this time is persists up to 30 minutes. The symptoms that are precipitated are easily reverted back by the use of these types of nitroglycerin. So these patients should be advised to keep on hand on these tablets along with them. The advantage to keep the medicines under the tongue is that it basically bypass the first pass metabolism of the nitroglycerin that occurs in the liver. Another important route is the transdermal route, that is also bypass the hepatic first pass effect. Furthermore, we have different types of the nitrogen oxide synthase that are present in the human: neuronal nitric oxide synthase, inducible nitric oxide synthase, and the endothelial nitric oxide synthase. They are basically, neuronal are involved in the nerve tissue, skeletal muscles, and inducible are basically a part of the cardiovascular and immune system, while endothelial nitric oxide is basically responsible for the vasodilation. So these effects may lead to the as they are basically depending on the nitric oxide, some CNS effects are also there. The selectivity of the effects are not there. That will lead to the adverse effects. There will be a vasodilation in low concentration, like it dilates the vein. There may be a venodilation, that is also decreases the venous return to the heart, decrease the chamber size. They also reduce the systemic vascular resistance. They also decrease the blood pressure, and they also dilate the meningeal vessels that can cause headache. Bahut hota hai isse. There may be change in the heart rate. There may be slight increase of the reflex tachycardia. The cardiac output slightly reduced. Mainly, इवन लो डोजेस कैन कॉज द डायलेशन ऑफ द आर्टरियोस ऑफ द फेस एंड नेक दैट कॉज द फ्लशिंग. देयर मे बी आर चेंज इन द ब्लड प्रेशर एंड इफ द चेंज इज एब्रप्ट स्पेशली इन केस ऑफ हायर डोजेस देयर मे बी वेनस कूलिंग एंड देयर मे बी अ डिक्रीज आर्टेरियल रेजिस्टेंस एंड दिस रिफ्लक्स कॉज द पोस्टुरल हाइपोटेंशन. Then there may be a reflex tachycardia and peripheral arterial constriction that tends to occur to restore the systemic blood pressure. Initially, coronary blood flow may increase transiently. However, subsequently it decreases the blood pressure due to its dilating effect. And due to this increased collateral flow to the ischemic areas, it normalizes the blood flow to the region of the area where there is a damage or there may be a redistribution of the blood. It also dilates the stenosis and reduces the vascular resistance in the ischemic areas. Peripherally, it reduces the pooling of the blood, reducing the preload, and the effects are mostly predominant in the sublingual tablets. You should remember that orally these nitrates are ineffective due to the high first pass metabolism and it should be administered sublingually. Problem is that there is a tolerance. Repeated dose lead to the tolerance and there should be a dose spacing. Reasons of tolerance is to decrease the capacity of the vascular small smooth muscle cells to convert nitrates to the nitric oxide. That is called true vascular tolerance. Pseudo tolerance may be there due to the different types of reasons. Due to the cerebral meningeal vasodilations, there may be headaches and these may be disappear after the continued use or there may be a decreased dose. There may be a transient episode of the weakness, dizziness and there are symptoms of postural hypotension. Some allergic reactions may occur after the use of the these types of drugs. Furthermore, phosphodiesterase esterase inhibitors, for example sildenafils and nitrates, if they are given concurrently, they can produce the severe hypotension because of the same mechanism as phosphodiesterase esterase inhibitors also increases the nitric oxide in the body. They are mainly reserved for the anginal pectoris, congestive heart failure and the myocardial infarction. There is no other any other use for the nitrates. If it is given for the prophylaxis, then it requires higher doses due to the first fast metabolism and isosorbide dinitrate 20 mg or more every 4 hours or mononitrate once a day or twice a day is considered. And other routes are also considered. These are cutaneous routes that we are applying the ointment in a form of the patch. Transdermal nitroglycerin basically it is a disc that is injected or impregnated with the nitroglycerin polymer having a gradual absorption and 24 hour plasma nitrate concentration. The onset is slow, however it provides a good results, but patient compliance is very less as it is in a form of transdermal patch, so it is basically dependent on the external source for its administration. Various clinical studies now prove that there is a very good beneficial effect of the beta blockers in angina, and now beta blockers are considered as a first line therapy for the treatment of the angina. It reduces the mortality as well as the chances of the progression of conversion into myocardial infarction and heart failure is also reduced. How they are functioning? They reduce the myocardial oxygen demand by blocking the beta adrenergic receptors present in the heart, decreasing the heart rate and decreasing the force of left ventricular contraction, and also decreases the blood pressure. The decrease in heart rate is also reduces the energy needs on the heart, but it also permits its better perfusion. And now the blood is easily perfused in the coronary circulations. Beta blockers also reduce the oxygen supply, oxygen energy demand of especially in case of the arrhythmias, and they also counteract the cardiac effect of the hyperthyroidism and pheochromocytoma. Beta blocker is not mainly reserved for the hypertension. However, now the indication for the beta blocker is now converted into the angina and or arrhythmias, or due to the hyperthyroidism, blood pressure due to the hyperthyroidism, or due to the pheochromocytoma. During therapy, heart rate should be carefully monitored, and the heart rate should be set up to the 60 beats per minute. The most important problem or interaction that is occur along the use of the beta blocker is the use within the diabetic patient, as the production of the insulin is under the adrenergic system. Thus, their concomitant use may worsen glucose control. Beta blockers can also mark the symptom of the hypoglycemia, and in patient who have the combination, so this combination should be considered that either there may be a risk of the hypoglycemia if insulin injection is given by a, is taken by a diabetic person. Even physicians are not consider this problem, and they believe that the benefit of taking the beta blocker even in a diabetes is more, it outweighs the risk, and they are frequently prescribing the beta blockers in diabetic patient as well. You will see several types of prescription in which the person is diabetic and there is an angina, and the physician is prescribing the beta blocker. However, caution should be considered, and proper monitoring, glucose monitoring should be there, should counsel the person that he should continuously monitor his blood glucose when he is taken or she is taken the beta blocker along with the insulin. Then another problem with beta blocker is that they have the tendency to cause the bronchospasm and the peripheral vascular spasm due to the beta 2 blockade. This beta 2 blockade is lead its indication that they are mainly contraindicated in the asthmatic patient. Asthmatic patient ko to hum kisi hal mein beta blockers, especially non-selective beta blockers, nahi de sakte. Similar with that case of the COPD, which is the chronic obstructive pulmonary disease, and similarly with the peripheral vascular disease, PVD. Another problem related to the beta blockers is that they cannot be used in the acute heart failure. If the heart failure is starting, then we can't use the beta blocker because it further worsening the heart failure condition of a person. And we also know that angina may convert into the myocardial infarction, and myocardial infarction may lead to the heart failure. So if the progression of disease is there and it is uncontrolled, then we will switch to the calcium channel blocker instead of the beta blocker. Another problem is related to the bradycardia, and the same reason is that they have the cardio suppressing effects. पूरे कार्ड को दे हार्ट को जो है बेसिकली सप्रेस कर रहे हैं, हार्ट का जो नॉर्मल फंक्शन है उसको रिड्यूस कर रहे हैं. तो इट इज मोर गुड चॉइस फॉर द एंजाइना इन विच वी आर बेसिकली फोकसिंग ऑन द रिड्यूस वर्कलोड ऑफ द हार्ट. हमें हार्ट का काम कम करना है तो एंजाइना में इट्स ओके. हाउएवर इन हार्ट फेलियर, इन ब्रेडिकार्डिया, वी नीड सम फंक्शन ऑफ द हार्ट, एंड वी कांट कंटिन्यूअसली ब्लॉक द हार्ट. हम ये नहीं कर सकते कि हम 100% हार्ट के फंक्शन को ब्लॉक कर दें. तो इन दैट सिचुएशंस ऑफ द हार्ट वी शुड अवॉइड द बीटा ब्लॉकर्स. कंडीशन लाइक इन एस्थमा, इन डायबिटीज एंड इन अदर सीओपीडी एंड पीवीडी, द मोर चॉइस, द गुड चॉइस इज टू यूज कार्डियो सिलेक्टिव बीटा ब्लॉकर्स. व्हाई कार्डियो सिलेक्टिव एजेंट्स आर प्रेफर, that are preferred because of their reduced tendency to cause these types of the bronchoconstrictions. Problem is that no beta blocker is completely specific for the heart, and agents with low lipophilicity, for example atenolol, penetrate the CNS nervous system, and they basically penetration is less and compared to the propranolol and metoprolol, and they can readily cause the nightmares. CNS effects hame atenolol ke case mein nahi milenge. However, metoprolol can penetrate in the CNS, in the lipophilic hai. The CNS effects bhi beta blockers ke hote hain. So if the person is psychiatric, or a person is having a comorbidity of the psychosis, then those beta blockers which have a serious effect, like they may cause the nightmares, they may cause the hallucinations, depression, and these may even worsening the depression and the psychiatric disorders. They also associated with the CNS mediated fatigue or lethargy in some patients. Furthermore, these drugs should not stop abruptly. Why they do not stop abruptly? Because of the fear of the reoccurrence of the symptoms of the angina. They may aggravate the symptoms of angina and also causing the rebound receptor hypersensitivization of the currently available of the agonist of the sympathetic nervous system in the body. It aggravates the symptoms of the angina. They are contraindicated in the Prinz metal angina. What is Prinz metal angina? Prinz metal angina is not due to the atherosclerosis, rather than it is due to the spasm of the coronary artery. So the effects are not depend on the blockade of the beta blockers, not related to the beta blockers. As the contributing factor of the angina symptoms are the coronary spasm. Mostly beta blockers are tend to reduce the renal blood flow as well, but this may only lead to the mild renal impairment. However, those, and furthermore, they are also eliminated by kidney. Those drugs which are nephrotoxic, if they are given concurrently with the beta blockers, they increase the chances of the renal damage. They may cause renal damage if along the use of the nephrotoxic drugs, just like vancomycin or other chemotherapeutic drugs. They may, these drugs are eliminated either by kidney or either by hepatic system. If they are excreted from the hepatic and renal system, then the person is already renally impaired, or there is an elderly patient, then the dose should be adjusted. Otherwise, elderly patients become more susceptible to the CNS mediated effects like hallucination, nightmares and depression. Theoretically, there may be an interaction along for those drugs which are eliminated through the liver. Interaction is not of so importance. Another important thing that should be remembered these are among those drugs which comes under the drug that they induce the heart failure. So there are certain agents which have the high intrinsic sympathomimetic activity. This due to the incidence ISA, those drugs which have the ISA have less chances for the induction of the heart failure. However, even there is no single beta blocker is there which is free from the this problem of the induction of the heart failure. Even if they have ISA, that is the intrinsic sympathomimetic activity, they have a tendency to convert the normal heart into the heart failure. So to prevent it, we must keep in the mind, and we should counsel the patient that he regularly visit the physician to adjust its doses according to its need of the person. This is all about the today's lecture. We have discussed two types of drug in this, that is the beta blocker and the nitrate. Other topics will be covered, just like calcium channel blocker, potassium channel blocker, will be discussed in the third lecture of the angina. Thank you.